Hello everyone! Today we should actually get started on some building. I have been thinking for a bit and I think that what I want to do is make this area kind of industrialized. I will show you what I mean in a second. However, one of the problems I'm running into is that I actually really want granite to use for this building, or for these buildings, since it has like this orange color. But I don't really have a lot of it, and to do so I would need a lot of stone. And I have a lot of normal stone, but I have not been going for granite, as you can probably imagine. So it's a bit difficult, and I don't really want to go for it because it seems a bit like a waste of time without a beacon. And I'm not able to get a beacon because I currently don't have enough materials. I have I need in total 1,476 of any rare materials, and we have maybe a total of 6-7-8 stacks, which is about one third. So yeah, we need more. And the ironic thing is that I actually get more by staying in this area and building. So if you have the iron farm here. So actually I should just get building, and then at some point we should actually get the thing. So the thing is that I kind of want to have roads made around this place, and I want them to be like gray and have multiple layers. But I'm not really sure that I actually want to end up with this iron farm, or I want to end up with it being here but not maybe looking like this. Maybe I want to create a building around it. I haven't really decided yet. So I want to give myself a bit of free space. This should be just above this one. So I decided to go 3 blocks out before I begin actually creating the corners. And I actually think I should go one more out just to be safe. So this is what I have done. The thing about me is generally when I work, I like to have a plan before we get going. So this is what I've been doing for the last couple of hours. And this is the sort of the design I want to go for. This is supposed to mean that it's going down and this is going up. As you can see, everything is exactly 5 blocks apart. That way it's really easy to calculate and make symmetrical. And this area is going to be for specific chests, like large storage of things like stone, gunpowder, like we have over there, but have it in a sort of center area. I placed them here in the beginning because I calculated wrong. And here we have some farms for wheat, I think it's potatoes, right? Yeah, carrots and so on, right? And yeah, this is the idea that I will try and work a bit on. I hope that you're starting to see the idea. I'm making like a little grave like this. Just gonna have to dig it out. It's just gonna take a while. A bonus of this is that we get all the materials that we need. Or at least some of them. It's beginning to take shape. It's something like this that I wanted. And as you can see, I'm starting to actually set up the new storage system. It's gonna be used for bulk storage. I've not really decided. I'm always switching around actually where the things are gonna go, but so far so good. I'm gonna need a lot of wood though, so I think it's time to actually begin removing this forest. Just can't hit this, can I? And this is the new mass storage. Now, there is space for a lot of stuff in here, and you might say, well, Stretchy, isn't this a few too many chests? And I only have one thing left to say to you. Yes, it most definitely is. This is way too many. Especially with all the shulker boxes we have. This is overkill. So, and I'm actually quite afraid that it's gonna... It already has impacted my FPS quite drastically, because chests work differently than other blocks. So, yes, I need to reduce the amount of chests we have, like, by a lot. How exactly, I don't know yet. So, this is my solution. It may look like I've just effectively halved the chests, which technically I have. There were 2 stacks of them. However, there's an idea behind it. So, let's say we have these 2 chests, right? We want to move the dirt up here. And let's say that the upper chest get full. Then, instead of just using more chests, we will use shulker boxes. So we fill the lower ones out with the shulker boxes. just something like this, right? That way we have technically an even bigger version before, just a bit more compact and will cause less lag. When I'm looking at my frames, I actually don't think that the amount of chests I had here actually made that big a difference, but I'm worried that it will in the long run, so that's why I'm taking care of it now. I am gonna do myself a favor and enchant this shovel with Silt Touch. That way I'm able to get some grass, which I know I'm gonna need later, since I'm taking away anyway. I feel like I wanna get started on like the fabric part of the industrial area. So first off, I think I'm gonna make a sheep farm of some kind. I'm having this idea of making like a triangle. So there's like farm here and farm here, and moves out on each side with the different colors. We'll have to work on it a little bit. There's so much land that needs removing, and I'm really not in the mood to go prepare my tools. I guess I can't postpone it anymore. Too bad. One thing I just realized about this farm is that it's gonna make the computer lag very quickly. Look at this. Just in a second. Already? A bit more. Yeah, now. That's incredible. There we go. 3 diamonds though. I could really use both an unbreaking book for this one and more mending books. I don't know if the best idea is to go AFK farming, AFK fishing, or to find a villager. I just decided that it would be easier to just make a new pickaxe and hope for a bit of enchantment. This is gonna be useful and useless anyway. That's quite good. Screw this one. Another feather falling one! Woohoo! We have 2 now! What else can we have? That's alright. There we go! Another feather falling 2. That means we can combine this one? Or these 2 actually. Feather falling 2. Feather falling 3. No! Alright, I guess I have to go back and do the rest. Note to myself, bring an anvil next time you go to the end. Yeah, that was quite successful. Got a few decent books. One, I think I got an unbreaking, didn't I? Yes. Okay. That's good. So, my idea for the sheeps is something like this. Like a little area. Sort of symmetrical. Where we can have all the sheeps of different color then. The question is how many? Maybe 8? 8 in each? Does not sound too unrealistic. I also need some wheat for this. And it's not like wheat farms are that difficult to create. Or at all, actually. I generally like using this setup. So because the water is able to affect blocks at 4 distance. 4 in each direction. This generally means that this is the most optimized per water. Yeah, just a little thought. And the fact that you're able to stack these makes them look even better. Now we need to find a sheep. It should be quite easy on this island. There we go. I'm so happy that we have leaves now. Generally, using wheat to get these ones around is... Yeah, for some reason it just like forgets it's following you and moves somewhere else. So it isn't that effective. So, we got the first 2 in. Once they have 2 children, I will move the 2 of them into the next one and probably dye them. And that will go on until we fill them up. Something I actually need is like cocoa beans for the brown color and jungle wood and savanna wood. What's it called? Acacia wood. Yeah. I can see there should be some of that in that direction. So I'll see if I can find some. Both savanna and a village. Other way around. This is nice. I can use this later. Leave this to be the nearest jungle, and it's over 2,000 blocks away. That's kind of incredible, actually. But yeah, gonna get some of these saplings and some cocoa beans. Oh yeah, I completely forgotten about vines. Gonna need some of those. I think I have everything I should need now. Some saplings, vines, cocoa beans, and more saplings. Quite good, if you ask me. A lot of brown color. That's nice. Okay, this is our first batch. Got to take these two. Okay, this worked better in theory, I guess. Can I get this one? You go back here. Perfect. I already think the third is one of those things I should stop collecting. I already have two sugar boxes, and I actually think I'm gonna partially empty this into one as well. I don't think I have sugar boxes enough actually to just to justify all the sugar boxes use. All the perfect. Almost halfway there. It goes quicker the more of them you have though, so it's gonna be easier. Okay, this should be the last one. Put it in here. Perfect. Now we have two in each. Now I need to beat these up, so there's 8 in each. A thing we have to be aware of, which I completely forgot. Sheep, they eat the grass to regain their wool. So if they don't have grass in the middle here or near them, they won't be able to regrow their wool. So we need to be able to make we need to make sure that there is grass nearby. I have also been collecting all the dice. These are the ones I could be find on the Minecraft Wiki. So we'll just make sure that we have two each. These should be black, red, and so on. If you're wondering, I am well aware that I'm able to make an automatic version of this, like an automatic farm. However, I don't really want to at this point because I don't often use wool, but I do sometimes, and just find it handy to have like a little bit of it available whenever I need to. So yeah. To make sure that they don't accidentally end up eating all the grass in here, I'm just gonna make it a step lower with grass as well. So there will be a layer of grass here, where it's able to spread from. Actually, now that I think about it, I could just do it like this instead of this. And this actually does look better and is more practical as well. How? It's blue. I don't get it. So now we have 8 of each. And this is great. We have all this built so far. So this looks really good so far. I'm thinking I'm gonna have to take a break. Even though I've actually been taking a couple so far. But I feel like this is a good time to end the video. And hopefully next time we'll be able to get a full beacon. If we're lucky a bit. One thing I just realized though is that as well the chests, I may have too many here. These do actually seem to cause some lag, so I don't know, yeah, I might reduce this. I don't know how far. But yeah. I also placed some shulker boxes here. So we can have all of it just next to it. But yeah, that's it for now. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.